Hi, in this video lecture, let's discuss about the synthesis of synchronous sequential circuit using JK flip-flop. Assume that we have given some word description, and from the word description, we have drawn the state diagram. And assume that there are four states in the state diagram, S0, S1, S2, and S3. And we are going to use binary assignment for the states. Therefore, S0 will get the value 00. S1 we are going to represent using 01. S2 is 10. And finally, S3 is 11. Using this binary sequence representation, we can get the binary coded state table as we are given here. Assume that we have done all these steps and we have arrived at this binary coded state table. There is no explicit output. We have only the internal state as the output of the circuit. We have an external input X, and since there are 2 bits required to represent each of the state, we are going to use 2 flip-flops, namely A and B. And we have decided the type of the flip-flop to be JK flip-flop. So, from this binary coded state table, we are unable to directly get the flip-flop input because the characteristic equation of JK flip-flop will be Q of t plus 1 is equal to J Q bar plus K bar Q. This is the characteristic equation of JK flip-flop. We have to use this input of J and K to get the output of the JK flip-flop. So we are unable to get the flip-flop input equation directly from the next state output. So how can we compute that flip-flop input then? When the flip-flop A is storing 0 and the input is 0, it is staying in 0. That means that I can say that this flip-flop A has retained its information. That is, no change. This is one option. Or I am resetting the circuit. We are trying to store 0. These two options will make sure that the next value that will be stored in the flip-flop A will be 0. So we have 2 options. Either J and K can be 0, 0, or it can be 0, 1. The input to the flip-flop A can be either 0, 0 to retain the state, or it could be 0, 1 to reset the state. In both the cases, when the previous state of A is 0, the next state will be ensured to be 0. If you consider these 2 inputs, J is 0 in both the cases, but K is 0 when we wanted to retain the information, and K will be 1 when we wanted to reset the information. So irrespective of the value of K, if J is 0, this condition will be met. So we are going to form something called excitation table having the input QT and QT plus 1. So QT is 0, here A is 0 in the previous state, and next state, which is QT plus 1, is 0. So in this case, J should be 0 and K value can be anything. And similarly, consider this combination. When A is 0 in the previous state and it is going to be 1 in the next state, in that case, I can either set the circuit to 1 or I can go for complement. From 0, I have to make sure that the next instance of value in A is 1. So I can set the circuit or I can complement the current state of the circuit. So in this case, k can be any value, but j will be 1. So when qt is 0 and qt plus 1, we require it to be 1, then we have to supply the input 1 to j, and k can take any value. So it is a don't care condition. So it is x. Similarly, when the previous state value is 1 and the next state value is going to be 1, we have these two choices. I can retain or I can set this condition, these two conditions. Maybe I will give a different marking. Either I can retain the information or I can set. So when you consider these two things, 0, 0 for j and k, and the other one is 1 and 0. So if you see this, k value is 0 and j can be anything. So j can be anything and k value is 0. When the previous state value is 1 and the next state value is 0, then we can go for resetting the input or I can go for the complement. So when we consider these two things, 0, 1, this row and the complement. In this case, k value is 1 and k, j can be anything. So j is don't care and k is 1. This is called excitation table, where you have the present state and the next state values, and if this is the case, what should be the input to the flip-flop is what we compute. So using this, now we can get the flip-flop input for the flip-flop A and B. When we wanted to have the present state as 0, the next state as 0, then we are going to supply 0 and k is don't care. So I say ja is 0, ka is x. When it is 0, 0, the same combination. When it is 0, 1, 0, 1, we are going to supply 1 and don't care. And this is what we have. Similarly, we can compute the flip-flop input for all combinations of the present state and the next state for flip-flop A as well as for flip-flop B. Once we have got all these information, then we can compute the flip-flop input equation by getting the simplified expression for each of these flip-flop inputs. There are three input variables, A, B and X, the present state values of the flip-flop A and B, and the external input X. So we will be using three variable Carnot map, and there is only 1, 1 here, which is equal to M2, min term M2. So we have 1 here, and we have don't care for 4, 5, 6 and 7, min term 4, 5, 6 and 7, and all these rows are x and there is only 1, 1 here. So we can combine these two ones and write the simplified expression as bx bar. That is the simplified expression for the flip-flop input for j for the flip-flop A. And similarly, I can use this column for ka to compute the simplified expression for the flip-flop A for the input K. So here M0 to M3 is don't care and only M7 is 1. So M7 is 1, from M0 to M3 we have don't care. So we can combine these two blocks and the simplified expression for KA will be BX. This is the simplified expression. And similarly, the simplified expression for JB will be, there are two ones and four don't cares. Don't cares are M2, M3, M6 and M7. M2 M3, so this is M7, sorry. So M2, M3, M6 and M7, and there is one in M1 and M5. So there are ones here, so I can combine these four blocks together and write the simplified expression. A is varying, the only term that remains the same is x. So JB is x, and finally we have to compute the flip-flop input equation for KB. KB, we have M0, M1, M0, M1, and M4 and M5. M4 and M5 is these two are don't guess, and there is a 1 in M2, there is a 1 in M2, and there is a 1 in M7. So these two blocks can be combined, and similarly I can combine these two blocks, and this block will be A bar, and what is constant here is X bar, and for this one we have A and we have X. So AX plus A bar X bar, so I can say it is the X NOR gate, so it is the complement of XR. So A XR with X, the whole complement will be this expression. Once the flip-flop input equations are found, then we can implement the block diagram. There are two flip-flops, flip-flop A and flip-flop B. So draw the flip-flop first. This is JK flip-flop, so each flip-flop will have two inputs, J and K. So this is going to be JA, this is KA, and this is JB, and this is KB. Supply common clock to both the flip-flops, since this is synchronous sequential circuit. Mark the label A and B. And this is the external input X. The input to JA is going to be BX bar. So this should be BX bar, and input to KA will be BX. So this has to be BX, and input to JB is simply X, and input to this KB is AXR with X, the whole complement. So let's see whether that is what we are supplying. So this line is going to be B. So this is B and this is B. This is X and this is X bar. And this line is X. This line is A. So what we get here is A and this is X. So A XR with X is this XR gate, and you have a complement here. So this is XNOR gate, and that is what we supply here. So this is the circuit that will do the function of the binary coded state table that we have started with.